ऑनरेबल जजेस मिस अर्चना अग्निहोत्री, मिस वैभवी शाह, मिस हेतल दवे, रेस्पेक्टेड प्रिंसिपल मैम, टीचर्स एंड पार्टिसिपेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। आई अनुष्का सुंदर, एनवायरमेंट एंड साइंस प्रिफेक्ट, वेलकम यू ऑल टू द फर्स्ट वर्चुअल साइंस एग्जीबिशन ऑफ योर स्कूल थाने। एज राइटली सेड बाय सर जगदीश चंद्र बोस, द ट्रू लेबोरेटरी इज द माइंड, वेयर बिहाइंड इल्यूजन्स वी अनकवर द लॉस ऑफ ट्रूथ। In the same spirit, the aim of today's science exhibition is to promote innovation and research-mindedness in aspiring young minds. We believe that this exhibition will serve as a launchpad to galvanize your thoughts and ideas into creative science projects and motivate further pursuit of scientific knowledge in you. Wishing the event and the budding scientists here good luck and great success. Thank you.
Hello everyone. My name is Anaya Rasoli, and the experiment which I am going to do is color changing walking water experiment. You can see the materials are kept here on the table. And there are three glasses, and in the two glasses there are water. This is yellow color and this is blue color. Now we'll see what will happen if we put the tissue paper. Did you ever think, why does the water move between the glasses? This process is called capillary action. Water is able to move against the force of gravity because the water molecules stick to each other and they stick to the fibers of the tissue paper. The adhesive force between the water and the fibers of the paper towel are stronger than the cohesive force between the water molecules. This allows the water to travel from one cup to another. Now, we'll come after some time and see what happens. Now, after some hours, we can observe that the middle glass, which was empty, now it is filled with green color, and the rest of the glasses, the water level has come down. This is because of the capillary action which takes place between these three glasses. The color is green because the mixture of yellow and blue equals to green. Thanks for watching. I hope you liked my video.
Hello all, I am Sudarshan Vijay from class 6H. Today I am going to explain the science behind thermostat. So I have two mastics like this. With the help of the third mastic, I am going to light this up. So if you see the second mastic when goes up, this is the sign, it is caused due to the temperature difference between the first half of the mastic and the second half of the mastic. So this technique is used in electric appliances. This technique is called as thermostat. This is the picture of the thermostat. So if you see here, there is a bimetallic strip. When this machine gets overheated, this bimetallic strip bends and further it disconnects the electricity flow. Thank you.
Hello my respected teachers and my dear friends. My name is Chaitan Chopra from UR School Thane grade 6B. Today I am going to show you an experiment that will help you in understanding density. First, you need to pour some water in it. in a glass. And secondly, we need to pour some syrup in it. And next, we need to put some oil. And as you can see, the three liquids have formed three layers because of the different densities, and they do not mix. And as the syrup has the highest density, it sits at the bottom, and the which oil has the lowest density rises to the top. And now I will show you that by putting some objects in it and see what happens. First, if I put a ball in it, it directly slips through oil, water and syrup and sits at the bottom. And if I put a pasta, it slips through oil and water and sits on the syrup, as the syrup is more denser than the pasta. And if I put a bottle cap, it sits on at the water, and because the water is more denser than the bottle cap. And if I put a sponge, we can see that the oil is more denser than the sponge. You can try this experiment with different objects and check which liquid is more dense. Thank you.
Respected teachers and my dear friends, my name is Jennifer Jerry and I am from grade 6H. And today I would like to perform an experiment on the topic colors of light. Light is composed of 7 colors. The reason we cannot see them all is because they are merged into one, white. When light enters a water drop, it refracts and splits into its component wavelengths or colors. Then it reflects inside the water drop and refracts once again as it exits it, forming a rainbow. Since rainbows are rarely seen, I would like to show how you can make a rainbow at home using simple things such as a tub filled half with water, a mirror and a flashlight. I will be placing the mirror in such a way that it is half submerged in the water. Then using the flashlight, I will make a rainbow. Violet color, which has the shortest wavelength, will bend the most and thus can be seen at the bottom of the rainbow. And red has the longest wavelength and thus can be seen at the top of the rainbow. Thank you very much.
Hello everyone. My name is Shri Aditya Das from grade 6C. Today I am going to show you all an experiment on air pressure. These are two glass jars. The air pressure inside them and outside them is the same. So, if I put an egg on it, it doesn't go inside. But if I place a burning camphor, and now I place the egg in it, it is getting sucked in. How did this happen? First, the egg was not getting sucked in, but now mysteriously it happened. How? The answer to this question is, the burning camphor uses all the oxygen present in the jar, and now the air cools and contracts, which takes less space. So if I put the egg inside, the air pressure is less. So if I put the egg inside, the outside air pressure pushes the egg inside, which is why the egg is getting inside. Bye!
My name is Ahana Kulkarni. I am from class 6G. My experiment's name is the flying tea bag. Now I have taken a tea bag and I am going to cut it and remove the tea from the tea bag. Now as we can see that I have removed the tea from the tea bag. Now I'm going to keep it and I'm going to burn it. I have kept two ready already, so I'm going to burn all of them three, and I'm going to burn a newspaper also. Now as you can see, the tea bag flies away. And as you can see, the newspaper does not fly. It turns into ashes. The theory behind this is that as we burn the tea bag, the air inside the hollow tea bag becomes hotter and the molecules inside the tea bag move very fast. Since the tea bag is a very lightweight, the tea bag flies away. In the same thing with the newspaper is a bit more heavier than the tea bag and hence cannot fly and turns into ashes. Thank you.
So this is a model of a sewage treatment plant. So this is a residential area. From the residential area, it goes to the sewage treatment. It goes to the sewage tank. And from the sewage tank, it goes to the screening. In the screening, the big particles get caught with the help of the screen. And then it goes to the gate chamber. In the gate chamber, the heavy particles settle down. Due to their weight, then it goes to the sedimentation tank. In the sedimentation tank, with the help of sedimentation, the fine particles get sedimentated, and from the sedimentation tank it goes to the aeration tank. In the aeration tank, we use air to encourage bacteria to decompose any remaining solids, and from the aeration tank it goes to the filtration tank. With the help of a filter bed, we filter the finest particles, and from the filtration tank it goes to the disinfection tank. In the disinfection tank, we use disinfectants like alum to disinfect the water. And from the disinfection tank, it goes to the distribution chamber. In the distribution chamber, it goes to the overhead storage tank.
Where is the overhead storage tank?
There is the overhead storage tank, and from there it goes to the gardening. It recycles in the form of gardening, and uses of toilets. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Takshin Murkar from grade 6F, roll number 31. I have made this project on water supplier. This is how it works. You have to take first an empty glass of water and keep it under the pipe. Then you have to press this button. A submersible motor will send the water from here to here through this pipe. As you can see, the water has filled. Thank you.
Hello everyone. My name is Vibhor Ushal Karthanis from grade 7D, Euroschool Thane. I have made this project to demonstrate how mechanical energy is converted to electrical and light energy. The materials used in this project are a large pulley, a rubber band, a small pulley, DC motors, the wires, and two electric bulbs. Now I will explain you how I have made this project. I have connected a large pulley to a small pulley with the help of this rubber band. The small pulley is attached to the DC motors. The two bulbs are attached or connected to DC motors with the help of the wires. Now I will show you how my project works. I will move the large pulley both clockwise and anti-clockwise. Can you see the bulbs glowing? I hope you like my idea. Thank you.
Hello all, my name is Paras and I am from class 7A and this is my science project Windmill.
So why do we need a windmill?
Let's see. There are two types of sources that generate electricity. Non-renewable sources and renewable sources. Non-renewable sources are not reusable and will get exhausted one day. And these also cause an adverse effect on our environment. Renewable energy is generated by renewable sources. Renewable sources are wind energy, solar energy. These types of sources are reusable and will never get exhausted. In addition, they also do not cause any harm on our environment. Now let's see how wind energy works. This is a windmill facing towards the direction of the wind. When the wind blows through the rotor blades move, activating the wind turbines. The wind turbines convert the kinetic energy of the wind to mechanical energy. Then it goes to a generator. The generator then converts this mechanical energy into electricity. Then it goes to a transformer. The transformer converts the lower voltage of energy to a higher voltage. Then it is distributed via the grid. Now let's see how it practically happens. This is a windmill. The air is blowing through this, which makes it spin. Then it goes to a turbine and then it goes to a generator. Then it goes to a transformer, which is then supplied to other resources through the grid. I hope you like it. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Shubhangi Ranjan. I am a student of grade 7G, Euro School, Thane. The experiment that I am making is going to prove that air has pressure. Air is all around us and pushing us from all the sides. Today I have made a water dispenser that will prove that air has pressure. To make this water dispenser, I used cardboard box, water bottle and a straw. I made a hole towards the down of the water bottle and put a small part of the straw in it. I fill the bottle with water and close the cap tightly. Now you will think that the water will come out from the straw, but nothing comes out. And you know why? This is because this cap is preventing all the air from coming inside the bottle and flowing through the straw. But now when I loosen the cap, all the air is allowed to come inside the bottle and pushes all the water through the straw into this glass. But when I tighten it again, the water flow stops right away. This is because this cap is again stopping the air from coming inside the bottle. This shows that air has pressure. Thank you.
Hello everyone. I am Pranay Banerjee from class 7A, Euro School, Thane. Today, I will be presenting a project on transformation of energy. My project is based on conversion of solar energy to electrical energy. Now let's have a look at the project. What is energy? Energy is defined as the ability or capability to do work. This is the sun. This is the farmer's house. This is the solar panel. This is the street light. Here is the pump. Here is the controller. This is the overhead tank. And this is the field. Now let's talk about the project. As you can see, the sun is giving out solar radiation, which is being absorbed by the solar panel here. The solar panel is converting the solar energy into electrical energy, which is used for switching this street light on. Now, the street light is providing light energy to the farmer's house here. Moreover, the solar panel is connected to this pump. This pump is used for activating the motor, which is taking water from this underground water reserve here and is giving that to the overhead tank, which is used for storage of water. The overhead tank is further providing water to this field and is helping in irrigation. And as solar energy is a renewable resource, we do not need to worry about its depletion. All you need is a solar panel, some sunlight, and you are ready to go. So that is how we utilize solar energy in a variety of ways without harming the environment by converting it to electrical energy. Thank you. That's all for today. Hope you liked my presentation.
Hey guys, I'm Samson Broji from class 7C. This time I'm going to show you my new robotic car, which is not made up of the kits which you get on the market, but made up of waste cardboard, which you can see written as Kit Kat over here. This moves in all slides, so it can go forward, it can go back, it can go right, and it can even go on the left side. Let me show you the demo. So this, it goes. This it goes right, then this it goes left, and then this it goes back, and then this it goes front. So this is totally functional. So this has a remote control made up of cars. And when it gets a light charge like this, it moves ahead. When it gets an opposite charge or the unlight charge, it moves back. So it's the same way and the easiest way to make it. This is the positions and all the arrangements of the tires for the proper movement. This is just for rotating for the front wheels, whereas the back tires are used for rotating, are used for the movement for all directions, which it is responsible to go ahead, back, right and left. This is totally wireless and doesn't have Bluetooth. Thank you. Bye.
Hello everybody. Today I am going to demonstrate a solar city. As you all know, a solar city works completely on solar energy. We receive 160,000 terawatts of solar energy from the sun, but we use only 16 terawatts of them. So my aim is to do maximum utilization of solar energy and then convert them into various other forms of energy for usage. The solar energy gets trapped in this battery, which is then converted into electrical energy and flows as a direct current to the street lights, and then the street lights lighten up. Similar things happen when the photons of the light fall on these solar panels in which PV cells are present, which convert the photons of the light into electrons. These electrons move as a current to the electrode and then it is converted into light energy and light is emitted. You all can see the bulb glowing. There is also solar panels on the roofs of other people's houses. People use these solar panels for their daily usages. Example, solar cooker, solar heater, etc. Not only that, but also, I have also put solar panels on these automobiles. In this case, the solar energy gets transformed into kinetic energy. So this is a green city which works completely on solar energy. Due to the urbanization, there is a huge emission of greenhouse gases leading to pollution. In this case, we should use a more cleaner and renewable source of energy to meet the needs of the urban areas. So in this project, I have used solar energy as the form. The benefits of the solar energy are, it is cost effective, modularity and no pollution, ability to combine systems. So let's have a clean city and have a green city. Thank you.
Good morning, dear principal ma'am, my teacher and my dear friends. This is my hydraulics project and it works on the basic principle of Pascal's law. Pascal's law states that when pressure is applied to a confined fluid, it transmits with equal force with no loss of energy. This is the basic principle of any hydraulic system. I would like to demonstrate this process. When I exert pressure on syringe A, my syringe B's piston will move up, which will make my hydraulic bridge elevate. Same applies to syringe D. I'm exerting pressure on syringe D so that my syringe C's piston moves up and it elevates my bridge. Now, the big shifts can pass easily without any obstruction. To get it back to its original position, we need to remove pressure from syringe A and B. When we remove pressure from syringe A, the bridge comes back to its original position. Same applies with syringe D. The Pambal Bridge in Rameshwaram is the first bridge, hydraulics bridge to be constructed in India. And the London Bridge is one of the greatest examples in the world. Thank you.
Hello everyone, my name is Yug Bajari and I am from class 7th. Today I am going to demonstrate an experiment on capillary action. Capillary action is very important for moving fluids. Have you ever heard about capillaries? Capillaries are those super small parts of a circulatory system. They wouldn't work without capillary action. It is also important in plants. The water moves upwards from the roots to the leaves. So let us begin now.
So for this experiment, we need 4 glasses filled with water and 3 empty glasses. We need red color, yellow color, and blue color, and 6 paper towels. We are going to add red color in the first and the last glass. And in the third glass, we are going to add yellow color. And in the fifth glass, we are going to add the blue color. We are going to dip it from the another side and whip like this.
Now all we have to do is wait.
As you can see, now the empty glasses are filled with colored water. This proves that the water has raised against the force of gravity. This is possible because of capillary action.
My name is Sharan. Today I am going to generate electricity by using salt water, insulated copper wire and aluminium sheets. So now the bulb is connected from one side, then I'm going to apply connect this from another side as well. And now as you can see that the bulb is glowing. So we did not use battery, and we generated using salt water. So I just quickly explain how did I do this project. So I took 7 glasses poured with salt water and took aluminium sheets, and I wrapped the wire against the hole. So I inserted this aluminium sheet in one glass and the wire in the other glass, and then I took 7 glasses, did the same. So I took 4 crocodile clips, 2 were red and 2 were black. So I attached 2 red clips with red wire and 2 black clips with black wire. So this is just a simple project, and thanks for watching my video.
Good morning all. I am Arya Kalpavriksh from grade 8B, and today I am going to be demonstrating the experiment of simple electrolysis of water. So now let's see the materials required. So now I have taken 2 iron nails with me, each connected to a wire, and these wires are further connected to a battery with a positive and a negative terminal. Now all I'm going to do is dip these 2 iron nails into this brine solution, and as we see, the nail which is connected to the positive terminal of the battery starts to attract molecules of oxygen towards itself, and it is acting as an anode while the other one acts as a cathode. Now, electrolysis was first invented by Michael Faraday, and electrolysis also finds many uses in various activities. Now, electrolysis is used in industry for the production of many metals and non-metals, example aluminium, magnesium, chlorine and fluorine. Electrolysis is commonly employed for coating one method with another, and this process, as we all know, is called electroplating. Now, why does the anode lose mass in electrolysis? The anode is a reducing agent because its behavior will reduce the ions at the cathode. Mass decreases as the reacting anode material becomes aqueous. So the site of reduction hence can be seen during the process of electrolysis. And why is direct current used in electrolysis? The direct current helps to deposit the anions in the anode and the cations in the cathode. If alternate current was used, then the direction of current will go on changing, and hence this would lead to an uneven deposition of ions. Electrolysis is also affected by many factors, and the factors that affect electrolysis are temperature, the surface area of the electrodes, the kind of metals, etc.
Hi, I'm Palak Lodha from class 8B. Today I'm doing an experiment to prove how much air styrofoam balls contain. You'll need some nail polish remover, a paper plate so that it doesn't melt away, gloves for protection, and styrofoam balls. Styrofoam balls actually contain 95% of air because during manufacture, air is injected into them. It has long chains of molecules. Acetone is a natural compound, and it has a formula of CH3-2CO. It is colorless and flammable. It evaporates quickly too. So now I'm going to show you how it is done. I've worn some gloves for protection, as acetone can be really harmful for your skin. So I'm going to start by spraying a little of nail polish remover acetone on our styrofoam balls. You can see it is clearly melting away. Well, what is happening? Styrofoam dissolves into the acetone, as you can see. The acetone splits up the chains of molecules and the air disappears, causing the volume to shrink. The styrofoam doesn't completely disappear, even though it looks as such.
Molecules are present in the leftover acetone solution. This shows how much air is in the styrofoam. See, as you can see, it has made some slimy stuff.
As you add more and more nail polish remover, as you can see, it starts melting away into thin air, but it does not completely vanish. It leaves behind a really slimy stuff. So I'm going to show you how it looks. Let me just quickly mix it all up. And you can see it. It is gray in color. It is actually full of styrofoam, but can't do anything right now. But it's like this. This is really harmful for your skin. That's why I bought some gloves. Thank you, teachers, for watching this video about how much air styrofoam contains.
Greetings, dear teachers and my fellow students. I am Malay Nima of grade 9A and I have prepared a simple science experiment based on the principles of hydraulics. In order to execute this experiment, I have taken 4 syringes and a pair of tubes to attach the syringes from their nozzles. And I have also prepared a small model of a bridge which is fixed to a pivot along which it can rotate or move freely. Let us now see how this experiment works. When force is applied on the plunger of the controller syringes, the water in these syringes is pushed through these tubes which are attached to another syringe fixed to the bridge. The water in this tube then directly pushes the plunger of the syringes upwards, which causes the bridge to move upwards like this. Similarly, when the plunger of the syringe is pulled, then it sucks the water from this syringe and the plunger of the syringe pulls the bridge vertically downwards, due to which it shuts close. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Rishitosh Nival and I have a very interesting project to demonstrate today. It's known as the Heron's Fountain. What's so different about this fountain? Well, unlike other fountains, it works on air pressure rather than water pressure. Before I start this demonstration, I just need a little bit of a setup to do. I need to fill this middle bottle with water. So, that's done. I'll just give a bit of an overview about how this fountain is going to work. So, once again, I'll pour water through this top funnel so that it goes through the red straw into the bottom bottle. Notice this air column right here. Now, if more water is filled through the red straw, this air column will get smaller and smaller. And thus, the air here will be forced into the middle bottle by the green straw. Now this area also has this much air only. Therefore, when more air is forced into this area, the air will be pushed downwards. This will cause the water to be pushed downwards also, and the water has no place to go but up, as the blue straw is the only thing connected right here, only straw connected. Therefore, when the water is pushed down, it will travel through the blue straw into the top funnel and it will go as a fountain. Now I'll just give a demonstration. Lastly, I would like to say that this fountain has great potential for generating renewable energy in the future. Thank you.
Hello everyone. My name is Sibangi Mishra and today I'm going to perform a small trick on making things invisible. Do you know how to do it? It is possible. Let's see. For this trick, you're going to need some borosilicate beakers, test tubes, vegetable oil and just common tap water. Now, we all know objects are only visible when light falls on them and they reflect or refract it. Whenever light passes from one medium to another, it changes its speed and this in turn changes its direction. This phenomena is known as refraction. The change in speed is measured from something known as refractive index. Now, let's try it out and see what happens. Here, I have a borosilicate beaker which is filled with water. I'm going to take another test tube which is also borosilicate and I'm going to dip it inside the beaker. We are still able to see it. This is because the refractive index of water and borosilicate is different. That is why light is able to pass through it and we are able to see it. Although some of it is being refracted, the rest is being reflected towards us. Let's try the same with a beaker partially filled with vegetable oil and water. The vegetable oil is floating above the water. This is because of its lower density. I'm going to take another test tube which is already filled with vegetable oil and I'm going to dip it inside the beaker. Watch carefully. When I dip this test tube inside the beaker, it is visible only in water and not in oil. This is because the refractive index of oil and the beaker is the same. Today we learned that if the refractive index of two substances is similar, the object inside vanishes, whereas if it is not, the object is visible. Thank you.
A pH indicator is a halochromic chemical compound added in small amounts to a solution so that the pH, that is acidity or basicity, of the solution can be determined visually. Hence, a pH indicator is a chemical detector for hydronium ions or hydrogen ions. Normally, the indicator causes the color of the solution to change depending on the pH. Solutions with a pH value below 7 are considered acidic, and solutions with pH value above 7 are basic or alkaline. Many plants or plant parts contain chemicals from naturally colored anthocyanin family of compounds. They show different colors with acidic and alkaline solutions. Extracting anthocyanins from household plants, especially red cabbage, to form crude pH indicator is a popular chemistry demonstration. This is a red cabbage. I'm going to use this as a natural indicator. First, I'm going to cut it into two pieces. Now, I'm going to chop it into more fine pieces. Now that I've chopped it into fine pieces, I'm going to add this in the mixer. Add some water. And then grind it. Now I'm going to strain this grinded cabbage. As you can see, my natural indicator is ready. And I've taken 8 different household items in each of these glasses. Namely, bleach, baking powder, sanitizer, sugar solution, water, Sprite, vinegar, and lemon juice. Now I'm going to add this natural indicator in all of these glasses and watch the color change. As you can see, the color of each and every glass is different from one another. As you move from acidic to basic solutions, the color changes from red to blue. Water being a neutral substance, it takes the purple color. By this experiment, therefore, we can understand, by using a natural indicator, we can understand whether a substance is acidic or basic in nature. Thank you.
Greetings dear teachers, parents and my fellow students. I, Himansh Garg, would like to present my science project in front of you. I have made an earthquake detector that works on the principles of electricity. As soon as there are some tremors, this red light starts blinking, indicating there is an earthquake. I have used a battery, a switch, a wooden stand, some wires, a hook, a screw and a light. This is the battery with one end connected to the LED and the other end is connected to the switch. The switch's end is connected to the screw and the LED's other end is connected to the hook. If you notice, the circuit is incomplete here. As soon as there are some tremors, this wire touches the hook and since hook is a conductor, it completes the circuit. And if the circuit is complete, this red light starts blinking, indicating there is an earthquake. Let me give a live demonstration of the project. If I have turned the switch on, as soon as there are some tremors, this red light starts blinking as the circuit gets completed here. Thank you.
We are what we eat. We all know that it is necessary to eat pure and unadulterated food items to remain healthy. And it is all the more important in these pandemic times. We all assume that branded products are pure. Is it really so? I'll show you simple methods to check adulteration in food. Check adulteration in tea powder. Take some tea powder. On a blotting paper and pour some water over it. If the tea leaves leave color, then the tea powder is adulterated. Here, the tea leaves are not leaving color, hence this tea powder is not adulterated. Coffee powder is generally adulterated with chicory and color. Take some coffee powder and mix it in a glass of water. As you can see, the chicory particles settle down and the water becomes colored. This shows that this coffee powder is adulterated. Milk is generally adulterated with starch or water. To check for starch, take some milk and add a few drops of iodine solution in it. If the milk turns blue, the milk is adulterated with starch. Here, the milk does not turn blue, hence this milk is not adulterated. Adulteration of ice cream. Take a ball of ice cream and add a few drops of lemon juice in it. If the ice cream is adulterated with washing powder, the washing powder will react with the citric acid to produce carbon dioxide in the form of effervescence. Here, there is no effervescence, hence this ice cream is not adulterated. Turmeric is generally adulterated with methanol yellow. To check adulteration for turmeric, take some turmeric and make a solution of turmeric and water. Then add some vinegar. If the solution turns pink or violet, the turmeric is adulterated with methanol yellow. Here, the turmeric does not change color, hence it is not adulterated. Pepper seeds are commonly adulterated with papaya seeds. To check the adulteration of pepper seeds, take some pepper seeds and put them into a glass of water. The actual pepper seeds sink in the water as they have high density while the papaya seeds float. Hence, this pepper seeds is adulterated. So you see, everything is not as pure as it looks to be. So be aware and eat healthy.
Hello everyone, my name is Piyush Maru and I am from class 10B. So for the science exhibition, I will do a small experiment today which is called Smoky Fingers experiment. So for that we need a scissor, a small dish, a matchstick, matchboxes and a paper at the last. So first thing we'll do is that we'll cut off this part of the matchbox, this part. So I'll do that. And please take care that you cut off this part from the edges properly. After you cut it, you have to just peel out this top layer. So I'll peel it out. So as you can see, I've peeled off this top layer. Now I will burn it. So I've burned this paper. Now I'll take off this. Now as you can see, there is a small sticky substance over here, yellow colored substance. So for that I'll take a paper and now I'll show you the vapors. I'll take this in my hand and now see this. As you can see, vapors are coming out from my hand. I'll take some more. The vapors are coming out. So the reason of this thing was that this part of the matchbox, it contains red phosphorus, and according to chemistry, when red phosphorus is rubbed in the hands, vapors are produced. Red phosphorus changes to white phosphorus, and thus we see white vapors. So this was my small experiment. I hope everyone liked this experiment. Thank you.
Hello everyone, I am Aman Mehdi from grade 10th of Euro School Thane, and this is my science project related to the working of suction. This is a homemade fountain made with reusable materials. For this experiment, I have taken a bucket of water, filled it in such a way that it would just immerse the motor inside. I have taken a plastic bottle, made some holes at its rim, attached the motor to it. For decoration, I have added some flowers, inserted some pebbles, and I have also attached some lights by cutting the bottle of water. So what is suction? Suction is the force created by partial vacuum exerted on a solid, liquid or a gas. It is the increase in the chest cavity which results in the decrease in the pressure inside, creating an imbalance between the ambient air pressure. This results in suction. So when the electric motor is powered by electric current, the water from the bucket gets driven into the empty water bottle. Then the water starts filling the water bottle, and as soon as it reaches the rims of the bottle, water starts squirting outside due to the high pressure created in the bottle. So now we would test the experiment by providing electric current to it. So now we can see that water has started rising into the bottle. As soon as it is reaching the rim, the water has started squirting out due to the high pressure created in the bottle. Doesn't it look beautiful? It is a simple science technique used to create something unique. It is worth a watch. Hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you so much for watching.
Hello everyone, I am Tanishka Akode from grade 10A, and today I will be showing you an experiment on floating ping pong ball. Before that, let me ask you a question. How does an airplane fly, or in what principle does it work? It works on the principle according to aerodynamics called Bernoulli's law, which states that the faster air moves, the less pressure air exerts. This creates the lift that powers the plane upward. Now, the material needed for the experiment is a ping pong ball and a hairdryer. How does this happen? The ping pong ball flies up from the hairdryer until it reaches a point where the force of gravity pulling the down below is equal to the force of air pushing it up. The air coming from the hairdryer is much faster than the air around it. Since the air is faster, there is a low pressure than the air around it.
the ping pong ball stays within the column of low pressure of air than because of the high pressure surrounding it. If you don't have a hairdryer, you can use a half kit bottle and a straw inserted in it and then blow the air from here. Thank you.
Hello everyone. My name is Rucha Bachmatia and I am a student of grade 9. Today, I will be performing an experiment titled Light Dancing to the Beat of the Sound. The aim of the experiment is to prove that sound produces vibrations. The materials required are a tin can cut open at both the ends, a balloon, some lasers, a mirror, and a speaker or a woofer. So the first step is to cut the tin can open at both the ends and then blow the balloon and cut it. Then place it over the tin can covering one end. Then take the mirror to the balloon. So now we adjust the tin can in such a way that it reflects the laser light back onto the screen. Then after adjusting the setup, adjust the laser light in such a way that the light falls onto the mirror. The mirror will reflect the laser light back onto the screen. What will be happening next is that we will play some music due to which the balloon will vibrate, which in turn will produce vibrations in the mirror. Because the mirror will vibrate, the reflected laser light on the screen will also vibrate. Hope you all enjoyed the video.
Good morning, everyone. I'm so excited about this science exhibition that we've just had, and we are about to announce the winners of each of the competitions. Well, I would like to really congratulate all the participants from grade 6 to grade 10 for their extremely enthusiastic participation. The judges have told me what a difficult task it was for them to select winners, because according to our judges, each child was a winner for his or her very innovative participation, and all the exhibits were really commendable. I would also like to compliment our science faculty for this extremely innovative idea that they came up with, and this too on a virtual platform. Online learning has reached another level altogether with this science exhibition that we've just held. And we look forward to the day when we don't just have an inter-house or an in-house science exhibition, and we take it forward to an inter-school science exhibition. So congratulations once again to each participant, to the winners, and to the entire science faculty for organizing such a wonderful exhibition. Kudos to all. Thank you.
Hello. My warmest greetings to you all and heartiest congratulations to all the winners of the virtual science exhibition. Science is all about curiosity, experimenting, and exploring. It is my privilege to propose the vote of thanks and acknowledge the contribution of all those who worked really hard to make this virtual science exhibition happen. I, Arnav Patra, head boy of Hero School Thane, and the entire fraternity of the institution, first of all, extend our most sincere thanks to our respected principal, Ms. Jyotsna Maya Das, for being the catalyst who stimulated us to do our best and stood as a pillar of strength. Ma'am, it is because of your motivation and encouragement that we were able to make this event a resounding success. A special mention to Ms. Gurinder Kaur, principal of Euroschool Ahmedabad, who spared time from a busier schedule and supported this venture. I wish to express my gratitude to the judges, Ms. Archita Agnihotri, Ms. Hetal Dave, and Ms. Vaibhavi Shah for your time and effort in judging the event, and we look forward to your association in our future events as well. I am thankful to our coordinator of grades 8 to 10, Ms. Dipali Madhvi, and our coordinator for grades 6 to 7, Ms. Lata Raman, for the constant guide and support. An event like this cannot happen overnight. The wheels start rolling weeks ago. It requires thorough planning and an eye for detail. I want to express my heartfelt gratitude to the key strategist and the visionary of this whole event, Ms. Bharti Randive, who is also a senior head of the Department of Physics, along with the senior head of the Department of Chemistry, Ms. Shashikala Pujara, and the senior head of the Department of Biology, Ms. Gargi Banerjee. Also, I am grateful to the entire team of proactive science teachers for their relentless efforts to bring out the future scientists to the limelight. I would like to take this opportunity to place on record our hearty thanks to Mr. Rahul Nikam, IT head of Euroschool Thane, for the perfect logistic support and guidance he has extended to all of us. A sincere gratitude to all the parents and well-wishers for your rock-solid support system and encouragement. Without your support, we would not have been able to achieve excellence. Thank you so much for your valuable contribution. I would like to thank our budding scientists who have elevated the standards of this event. Your days of hard work were evident in your demonstrations and experiments. All the activities were very captivating and creative as well. Last but not the least, I thank my fellow colleagues, the Senate members, for rendering your support whenever needed, wherever needed. I thank you, my friends, from the bottom of my heart. I wish and pray to Almighty to shower His blessings on all of us and all of you who are watching our show. Stay safe. Hope to meet you all soon. Till then, happy sciencing.